The Best Hit USA。 こんばんは、小林和也です。アメリカのホットな情報と最新のヒットチャートをお送りする Best Hit USA。 まず話題のアーティストを紹介するホットメニューのコーナー、今週はこの方をスタジオにゲストとして迎えております。
I don't want to date myself here.
Yeah, well,
14 years.
How was the encounter? Was it, did you buy it?
Well, actually, the first guitar that I got, my grandfather gave to me. It was made out of plywood, and it was had palm trees painted on the front.
And
it was a cowboy guitar.
And he taught you?
No, I taught myself. And got my first good electric guitar when I was about... 16 or 17, and that's when I got serious.
Mm-hmm. And came up with a band?
Yeah, well, I've played in all kinds of different bands for a long time. And then I was asked to join Triumph 1975.
75?
Yeah.
Was it 76 when you came up with the first record?
Yeah, that's right. Yeah. Mm-hmm. We actually made two records in Canada before we had a record deal in the States.
Mm-hmm.
And that first record in the States was called Rock and Roll Machine. That would have been about 78, I think.
Yeah, and this is the seventh album,
right.
Stages, and you're here to promote. Tell
right.
us about the album.
Here it is. zoom in. Look, isn't that beautiful? Well, we recorded it on about... 3 or 4 tours, actually. And we had we have our own studio in Canada, Metalworks. And we had a lot of tapes in the library from Never Surrender tour and the Allied Forces tour. And then, of course, the Thunder 7 tour as well. So we decided that it was about time for a live record, and we sifted through all the tapes, and we were able to get enough good ones that we had a record.
So this is sort of the best, or the cream of Triumph.
I guess so. It's more like like a stepping stone, or there's a historical retrospective kind of feel to it. It's almost like a greatest hits package in a way.
Yeah.
Even though I guess here in Japan we haven't really had any great hits, but...
you're more what? Album oriented.
Yes, right? That's right. Album oriented radio in the United States.
Most of the songs are long, and that make less exposure on radio, right?
That's exactly right, yeah. Huh. Yeah. We're not really a singles kind of a band. And our following, our fans usually come from live performances and touring. That's how we built our following in the States.
Mm. Do you. What do you want to label your music? I mean, there's so many categories and new.
Well, I'm not much one for labels. You know, I hate to have to do it, but I guess most people would say we're just a hard rock band. We're not really heavy metal. We sort of fall somewhere in between. I would say bands like Journey and those style of bands.
Motley Crue.
That's on the other side. The Judas Priest, Iron Maiden, Motley Crue. That's sort of the more straight heavy metal.
Metal thing.
Yeah, we're not as metal as that, but we're not as soft as say Journey or a band like that. So we're somewhere in between, a little bit like melodic.
Oh yeah.
Metal.
Do you watch the music scene objectively? You know, the Heavy metal is coming up and new wave going down? Or,
not really. I don't pay too much attention to fashion. I'm aware of it. I know what's hot and what's not. But I don't really let it affect what I do as an artist. I try and play the things that I like, and I try and do the best that I can at that. And I just hope that people will be able to relate to that. And I think in the long run, they will. I think that's what longevity of a career is based on, people being able to relate to you artistically. Mm.